Oh. Bro. What are you selling me here? Why is a little human inside of this capsule? What? Yeah, all right, everybody. Welcome to the Indie Showcase with the Birdman. I am said Birdman. This here is Intergalactic Pawn Shop Prologue, which means it's available to you guys. I'll have a link for you down below in case you want to check it out for yourselves. This one intrigued me for various reasons. Mainly, it's going to be, at the core, a pawn shop type of game in space, in the future. We have played many games in the past where pawn shops were kind of like the main premise, and they just make really fun showcases for the game, and also just banter in general because of what they consist of. This one intrigued me though because it kind of also has a narrative alongside, kind of like your Papers, Please or your Human or Not, where you're doing one job, but obviously there's little stories going around you. And even though you think you're all about the job, this job somehow branches into the stories of the happenings around you, so it seemed intriguing in that regard. Without further ado, let's check it out. The Earth has become uninhabitable. Irradiated desert. In order to survive, humanity had to flee. It is 2210. Those who were able to escape settled on a planet called Korra. Korra is a hotbed of revolutionaries and corporate spies all seeking to shape the planet's future. As if that isn't enough, the tension between the humans and the alien Lork is reaching a boiling point, and even the actions of an employee could influence the destiny of all. Are you ready to change history? Nah, I'm good.
Hey, Frank, I have upgraded your equipment. Let me give you some quick information.
I'm all ears.
Okay, let's start with the computer. Any object brought by the customer can be dragged onto this for quick research.
Cool.
You can also use your phone, spectrometer, electronic weight scale, and magnify in the same way to gain information about the object.
Cool.
Drag objects onto the equipment or simply click on your equipment, it's your call.
Cool.
And you have a turbo lift button, use it to invite the next customer. Oh, I almost forgot, the items may have damages and may look dirty. Use the repair station to your left. It's also a grinder inside you can use to get rid of the items in exchange for raw materials. When you want to sell the items, place them on the shelves of your display area for all to see. People will buy them from you directly. That's all. Good luck.
Okay. No, feed the cat. Feed the cat. Hey, buddy. There you go. Oh, we even have a pet.
What do we got over here? Oh, look at this guy. Look at this alien.
Get out of here, alien. We don't serve your kind around here.
Oh!
What does my computer say? Vision Pro, produced by Pineapple Inc., weighs approximately 520. It has experienced technical glitches and compatibility issues with some devices, and its adaptive feature may not always adjust accurately to lighting conditions. Meanwhile, people couldn't afford to buy tickets off old Earth were left to their fate, immersed in their Vision Pro headsets as the world ended around them. So it's a VR headset. How much does this weigh? It might be genuine. This is a pair of old tech VR glasses.
Oh my god, really? So they're more valuable than I expected?
Yes, even scrap price is 80. No, they're worth less than goggles. Why?
Nah, let's be legitimate for now.
What is your offer?
Well, we said what?
300. 100, 300.
I mean, I'ma offer you the 80, dog, and I'ma see if I could, perhaps get this boy on the shelves for 300.
He said yes. So I am curious now that I have this. I got a 5-star rating. Very good. You see, a little bit of honesty. You didn't expect that from me. Oh, Falcon's gonna lie to this poor man. No, I'm not a scumbag every single moment of the day.
So if we tag it for cleaning, it's gonna go up to 170. And if we tag it for repair, 250. So let's make sure that we do both of those, because I wanna see how this works, this repairing function. So let's come over here and see about my boys. We're looking for 2, 2, and 4 all around, thankfully. I mean, we have a 2 here. Would you be blue? Let's find out. If I feed you here, right?
Yes. So you're already at 2. That's perfect. Now, since we're at 2, we want to make sure that it's kind of like moved in that direction. So perhaps we do something like that.
I make 4 what I got here. I mean, I could. I could do 6, 3, 9, negative 5, 4. So, boom. 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 Hey, look at that. He knows how to do basic arithmetic.
Impressive. Very nice.
And then it's going to take 140. Okay, there we go. And what about the cleaning? You'll clean by yourself? Yeah, maybe. Cool. All right. So that's going to be repaired. Oh, you need your food. All right, there you go, buddy. All right, that worked out pretty good. Next person? I was about to say next patient. Man, that cat eats very loud.
Hey there, Frank. You won't believe the day I've had.
I'm not interested in your story. Let's focus on business. Hey, buddy. Spill the beans. What crazy adventure have you been on today?
A marvel of fire and steel, an ancient art of death.
Hold your horses, Mike. I will check the materials with my spectrometer. So one's gonna... I already done this too, though. Alright. I mean, what can I say? I just like to learn things myself. Okay, cool. So, this is iron and nickel. And silver and platinum.
So, what do you think?
Where did you find this?
I found it in my grandfather's basement. This belonged to my great-great-great-great-
2 hours later.
A katana is a traditional Japanese sword known for its distinct appearance and cultural significance. Ancient katanas used by the samurai have a sigil on their handle. However, scammers are offering fake products to the market. Email received? That's probably because my thing's ready, right? The best way to distinguish real from fake is its material. Traditional katanas contain 58 to 60% iron. Uh-oh. I mean, I gotta turn a little profit, you know what I'm saying?
Okay, you got it.
Hey. So, speaking of which. Oh, I can't leave my desk when people are here. Are you hungry again? Another 5-star, very good. Put you. 80 is what it costs me, right? Yes. But we said it could go up to 300, was it? Yeah, let's go a little. You know what? Do 300. I was going to lower it, but here's what we do. 300, then we'll put a little 10% tag on it where people are like, wait a minute, it's on sale? You're like, oh, I can't pass that up. It's on sale. And put this bad boy for sale too. So 451 is what I paid for it, right? We set up to 800. A little 800 on it. But then we're going to slap a little 15% on it. Exadia Falcon? Maybe a 10%. A little going a little bit too crazy. I gotta make some money, you know? What the hell is this guy? Oh my god. Sorry, sir, this is not GameStop.
Hey, I wanna buy this item you put on display. Oh, yo! Yo, it worked already!
Sure thing, 720.
Thank you. Have a nice day. What are the odds? What are the odds that homeboy who I said, sorry, this is not a GameStop, comes in and he wants to buy the katana? All he needs is literally a fedora.
Who are you, Dr. Nick Riviera?
Hi, everybody!
Hello! I have an excellent collector's edition game for you.
Let me guess. A priceless relic from the past? Nah, don't be a dick. What is it?
Don't buy this game.
Cool. Bye now. Why?
No, you misunderstand me. Don't Buy This Game is the name of the game. It contains 5 CDs and each one has one of the worst games ever made.
Oh, that's how you use this bad boy, huh? Where is the barcode? Oh, there it is. Don't Buy This Game, also known as Don't Buy This Game, 5 of the Worst Games Ever, is a compilation of video games for the ZX Spectrum. Released on April 1st, 1985. April Fool's. As stated in the box, it features 5 of the poorest games submitted to the publisher, Firebird. Instead of rejecting these submissions, Firebird chose to mock the original developers by releasing the games altogether, branded them together as unoriginal and awful. The barcode of the real version ends with 255, so it might be legit.
I will buy the newest game, Skyrim 8, if you give me something good.
Oh, really? So in the year 2210, Skyrim 8's gonna come out, huh?
Are you sure about that?
I mean, you could buy yourself Skyrim 8 for a nice little DAO, right? Wow, you were expecting that much, huh? Look at this guy. All right, my friend. You have one more last offer. I'm gonna give you... It's probably easier for you to just type it out. 1601. I mean, come on, dog. Fine.
I never have.
Go base value. And then we're gonna drop a nice little. Let's see what 15 does for me now. We bought it for 1700, so we get 1100 profit. It's not too bad. I'll take it. Okay. Hey, Gat, there you go. Dog, you gotta stop eating now. I'm telling you. We have to do something about your dying here pretty soon. Next. You missed the guy with the katana. He would have my lady to you easily. This is Madame Von de Boras. Hello. Welcome to the Intergalactic Pawn Shop. I am Madame Von de Boras. I specialize in offering insights and guidance to people seeking clarity in their lives. Mm-hmm. And I am looking to let go from my collection. Let me consult my expert friend over the phone just in case. Oh. I guess I haven't used that before, huh? Do you want to call an expert for 250 coins? I mean, I guess. Gots to, huh? Hey, yeah, these cards are valuable in the hands of the people who read them. But you can check if they're original or not. Original cards can be considered as collectibles. They have a tiny logo of a pentagram within a circle on the card. Just like the one you have. Do we gotta do anything else over here? I doubt it. Have we met before? Am I gonna start hanging on this woman or what? Oh, it's just she's calling us by her name. I see. How do you know my name? Well, I mean, she divines the future, dog. That's with the cards. She used the cards before she came in. My cards, there you go. My card showed me many things, but it is nice to meet you nonetheless. Nice to meet you too, I guess. If you'd open, I'd be glad to offer a reading for you. A glimpse of the path you're walking. I don't believe in witchcraft, well. I mean, I really don't believe in this stuff, but... you know, for the sake of the game at least. Go ahead. Well, pick a tarot card, please. Very good. I'm gonna die.
Well...
Let's just type it out, Doug. A little 451.
Okay, you got it.
Hey. I'm pretty sure we don't have to fix these either, right? Just good to go as is. So, how about we put these on auction? No? Try an auction. Put this in auction for one day. Buyout price is 50. Yeah, let's go for it. I like it. This is a very nice, comfy looking, domain, you know? I wouldn't mind having something this small if I was literally in space and I could just stare out the window and see space out there. This would be pretty baller. Let's go to bed. New mail received. What do we got? We sold for 1165. The tax went down. All right. So we didn't get the 1500, but we still made like, we paid 451 for it. Like, you know, over 600 for it. That's fine. That's good. Acceptable. Put this over here. And everything should be on the shelves. Anything needs fixing. Got a little bit of time for a bit more. So let's go a bit further. Not a bad one, to be honest, which I'm already liking it. Especially because there's so many different things to kind of like manage. And you're not being timed. These things are just annoying when you have like a timer where you're like, there's like 70 people waiting in line. So you're like, God damn, I can't really take in the narrative. I can't really read everything. It's everything to be like fast.
Yeah, I was clearing out my family storage unit and I found this hard drive.
What's on the hard drive? Oh, you don't want to know what's on the hard drive, dog. People's hard drives should remain their hard drives for a reason. During the first half of the 21st century, there was a trade in blockchain-based art assets. Cute. Sold almost exclusively by grifters and seen by many as a symptom of the late-stage capitalism that characterized the early 21st century. They had little to no value at the time, and they're still the same. It's true. It's absolutely true. All them NFTs!
Every single NFT ever made.
Oh, really? Wow. Man, can you imagine the value of this hard drive? Every single NFT ever made. Yeah, I've heard of them.
Cool. You can insert the drive on your computer to check them.
60. Just so I can break it down. Every single NFT ever made. I got grifted. You know, it's only 60, but I got definitely grifted. Oh, wow. I forgot that I have payments to deal with, too. I need to pay for oxygen and rent. You want to live? 250. Or else you don't get to breathe. Okay, so let's go ahead over here and... scrap it. I mean, I kind of want to scrap it, but at the same time, I'm also thinking, What if we could kind of grift somebody else with this NFT thing? Maybe somebody else. I mean, there's always a fool, right? I mean, how do you think this NFT took off to begin with? There's got to be a fool out there, right? Oh, he's here to buy the worst games. Yo.
Haha. Look at that.
Turning a little bit of a profit. Good, because I needed to pay oxygen so I could continue living. I was worried about that. Oh my god. Take anything you want. Take the gun. Here's the gun.
Hey there. Hey, I would like to sell this huge thing. According to my elders, it was used during the Black-Pink War in 2025 on Old Earth.
The Black-Pink War. That takes place next year. Huh. I could see it. Yeah, I could see it. The Black-Pink War?
Rumors suggest that the colors featured in films released in 2025 caused division among people. The war that ensued between those who aligned with the pink and the black sides resulted in the loss of many lives. As the conflict escalated, so did the complexity and scale of the weapons used.
I can't blame them, black rules. Pink is better than blank.
Typical humans. They always seem to be inclined to start a war. Ain't that the case?
I agree. Nevertheless, I hope there will be no war on this planet, Korra. Who even needs there to fight? The states are so weak. And though the megacorps occasionally fight each other, a full-on war would be bad for business. Some people say that it might happen between humanity and the Lorks, but who knows? The managers don't like Lorks. Lorks don't like managers.
I like cats. Hey, I got a little kitty over here. Matter if I'm gonna feed him.
War. War never changes. Oh my god, we were just talking about it too, weren't we?
Whatever, interested or not? Let's see what we got here. The pink atomic bomb used during the Black-Pink War on order, so he was legit about that. Barbenheimer brand and contained more than 80% uranium. That's a lot of money, this is legit. I feel like it probably won't be. I gotta start somewhere and build myself up. I'm willing to barter, but let me give you 3,000.
Rose, did I get... You know, I should have called this man. I should have probably called a 250 man. Why is this... What is this icon? What does this icon indicate? What is this icon? And I can't tag it for sale. I'm gonna sell it right now.
I don't know, dude. I couldn't tag it, okay? I don't want it. Okay, I don't want to, you know, have the business get like a bad reputation suddenly. And I don't want to put it for auction and then something happens. They're like, oh, this guy's over here trying to auction off fake items. The way this guy, quote unquote, unique, I don't like it. I'm going to take my 15,000 and just be happy. I got more than enough than I needed, okay? So I'd be too greedy.
Oh, mama.
I'm glad I did one more customer because I was about to wrap up. But I was thinking to myself, oh, let's just do one more.
I want to sell these, make it quick. I don't want to be in this filthy place.
Oh.
And you, you're also mean. Your dummy mind material.
What are these?
Don't ask questions. Just take... Okay. Don't ask questions. Just consume. Just take these and give me 50,000?
Use gun?
Bruh, what the hell is in here? Quick. This is a portable human? You want to sell me an illegal item? What?
Shrinking technology is used in many fields from the industry to shrink and transport heavy machinery, to ecological prevention of endangered species. They contain anything, any condition it is up for. You can even provide auction for up to 20 years according to the consumption rate of the creature inside.
Holy hell. Hey, dog. I need some info.
This device is made to shrink large items and store them inside. I can see a living human inside it. This can only be sold in the black market.
Oh. Bro. What are you selling me here? Why is a little human inside of this capsule? Mama? Oh, okay.
This is a portable human. You want to sell? I mean, I kind of want to take it. We can negotiate.
I didn't like your attitude. I wanted 50, not to haggle with a scumbag like you. Yeah, I know all that. If you just bought it from me, we could have avoided some pleasantries, but I have need of your services, okay? And no inclination to go through the inconvenience of recruiting. The device will be your new home. It's so...
What?
What is happening? Should I have gone for the gun? Should have gone for the gun, huh?
I don't know, dude. I'm confused as to what's happened. I was apparently released, and I'm back here again, and I got many questions, but you know, we're out of time anyway. But I'm so glad that I decided to do one more customer for that to happen. That was baller as hell. I don't even know where this is going, but hey, as I mentioned, I'll have a link for you down below. This is a prologue available. I'm not sure how much further it goes, but I'm kind of interested about the full release now, to tell you that much. If you are as well, let me know. Maybe we'll come back and check it out then. Not a bad one, to be honest with you. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. I'll catch you next time.